There's a reason work smart, not hard is a cliche. Effective studying more about how you study, not just how long. Studying TV focuses on getting the most out of every study session, and you should too. But for now, today's video.
The question, how many hours should I spend to study physics for the Iit Jee? It starts with how much you know and how much comfortable with physics you are. Because you are the one who will study. But let me guide you on some points. First and foremost, my suggestion would be that if you want to imagine, understand and do physics, rather than the conventional formula mugging, physics is all about imagining things, doing thought experiments, then give a full day to physics. Or 2 days. Or 3. Nothing in between. No other subjects. Till you can finally say, yes, I am confident in imagination. My dear fellow, that's the day you are ready with physics. Actually, the same applies to all subjects. 3 days for each subject with no diversions means you finish syllabus within 9 days. Not even 1 month, leave alone years. Isn't that cool? And I guarantee you, this works. First and foremost, my suggestion would be that if you want to imagine, understand, and physics, rather than the conventional formula mugging, physics is all about imagining things, doing thought experiments, then give a full day to physics, or 2 days, or 3, nothing in between, no other subjects, till you can finally say, yes, I am confident in imagination. Yes, I am confident in imagination. This works. This works. Now, what should be done in a single day? We start with basics. Take any good physics book and start reading. I would suggest Halliday, Resnick and Walker if you want a concept tour and a lot of intriguing sums. If you want a cool, mind-blowing, deeper understanding, go for the Feynman lectures on physics. The latter is a personal favorite of mine. Once you start, you cannot put it down. Don't jump the sums just by seeing the formulae. Try and think why the formulae are there, and why are they applicable. Ask yourself, are they general? If not, can I make them general? No? Then why not? Questions like this. On any topic you study. If you follow this, you should finish classical mechanics and thermodynamics by the first day. Halliday, Resnick, and Walker. The Feynman lectures on physics. Are they general? If not, can I make them general? No? Then why not? Second day starts. Start with anything you feel comfortable because the base is done. Anything. Modern physics, electromagnetism, optics, anything. Follow the same pattern of study. Third day, concluding up. Complete what is left. Practice sums but don't go for all. Instead, use a random generator to generate random question numbers and solve them. Google has an inbuilt random number generator. That should help you. If required, take a fourth day. I don't think you need more than this if you diligently study each day. 34 hours a day is enough. Don't stress yourself. 4 hours of physics, then have fun. Let me tell you a small incident how I had fun and what I ended up with. We were in standard 8 when there was a substitution class and a class 12 physics sir came to take the class. He didn't know our syllabus, so he told us about Planck and all. Using just the Planck formula and Einstein's mass-energy equivalence, which I knew at that time, I devised a whole theory of wave mechanics including de Broglie's hypothesis, and I even solved the Bohr model. I thought I had solved something interesting, until I found out it was already done. You can also try and do the same. It's actually interesting. Let me tell you a small incident how I had fun and what I ended up with. We were in standard 8 when there was a substitution class and a class 12 physics sir came to take the class. He didn't know our syllabus, so he told us about Planck and all. Using just the Planck formula and Einstein's mass-energy equivalence, which I knew at that time, I devised a whole theory of wave mechanics including de Broglie's hypothesis, and I even solved the Bohr model. I thought I had solved something interesting, until I found out it was already done. Last but not the least, whenever you study physics, or maths, think that you are learning something that made you up. Think that you are unraveling the mystery of your existence and the mystery of why you are studying your existence in the first place. That will boost your understanding and your concentration. Whenever you study physics, or maths, think that you are learning something that made you up. Think that you are unraveling the mystery of your existence and the mystery of why you are studying your existence in the first place. Whenever you study physics, or maths, think that you are learning something that made you up. Think that you are unraveling the mystery of your existence and the mystery of why you are studying your existence in the first place. I wish you all the best for all your exams and that you might have a bright future.